Hello, and welcome to today's video where I'll be covering my webcomic process in Clip Studio Paint. In today's video, we'll be taking a look at Clip Studio Paint's color adjustment layers, and the ways they can be used to create different color effects for your webcomics. Links to additional tutorials and everything mentioned in today's video will be down in the description below. In Clip Studio Paint, a tonal correction layer is a type of layer you can apply over your art to add different color effects or adjust your pre-existing colors. Among the list of available correction layers, some can be used for color correction and making tweaks, while others will completely revamp your colors altogether. To view the list of correction layers, go to Layer, New Correction Layer. What makes these tonal correction layers especially handy to use is that they exist on their own separate layer, which can be customized and masked off like a regular layer. This also means that layer modes will work with them as well, which opens up a ton of possibilities for how you can use them. Now let's take a look at a few of my favorite correction layer techniques. If you've ever found yourself wishing you had colored something a little darker, but don't want to start over from scratch, then the level correction layer may be what you're looking for. By dragging the slider arrows, you can control the brightness and darkness of your colors based on their values. This is convenient because it allows you to darken just the darkest areas without affecting the brighter spots, and vice versa. By switching the channels via the drop-down menu, you can also adjust the color temperature based on value as well, which can create some pretty interesting color palettes. If your comic uses traditionally drawn line art, one quick and easy way to prepare your line art for digital coloring is to use the level correction adjustment layer to boost the contrast between your lines and the background. You'll want to get the background as close to white as possible, and the lines as close to black as possible, while still preserving the quality of the line art. Then merge the adjustment layer with your scanned line art layer, and go to Edit, Convert Brightness to Opacity. Now the white background of your line art will become fully transparent, so you can color directly beneath your line art without issue. Another tonal correction layer that I like to use is the Tone Curve layer. On the surface, it works pretty similarly to the level correction layer. You can adjust the brightness and darkness of your work, as well as manipulate the different channels of color through the dropdown. The Tone Curve layer allows an even more in-depth control of how your colors and values are presented, and can also work with inverted colors. By dragging the nodes on the Tone Curve graph, you can see that the colors will radically shift depending on their place on the graph. I love using the Tone Curve layer to add some color variants to my work. It works great for creating rainbows and oil spill type effects, or for just adding a little distinction to your pre-existing colors. I'll drag the nodes around until I get a look I'm happy with, then I can play around with layer modes and opacity. Layer masks are another great way to use this layer type, as you can add in small areas of rainbow to otherwise uninteresting spots for added interest. Color balance is a great correction layer for making tweaks to your pre-existing colors. Each slider represents two opposite or complementary colors. The options at the bottom represent the different value levels from which the color balance layer will work. So you can use a combination of different shadow and highlight colors to get interesting results. As you can see here, by making the highlight color more green and the shadow color more magenta, I've gotten an entirely new look altogether compared to how I started. Color balance is great for adding an atmospheric feeling to your scenes, without having to add in too many additional layers. If you want to make something feel moody and intense, give your colors a blue or magenta shadow, or for something more lighthearted, try using a yellow or red highlight. Finally, my favorite tonal correction layer is the gradient map layer. Essentially, this adjustment layer applies a gradient to your work based on its values. To adjust the gradient, you can move around the nodes at the bottom of the gradient bar to position and recolor each section as you like. Gradient maps are my favorite tonal correction layer type because they have the most versatility with their results. By themselves, they can already create a really interesting color palette for your work without any further adjustment. They also create some very beautiful gradients when you draw using soft edge brushes. Using complementary colors together in a gradient can produce some fantastic color palettes that are really striking to the eye. If you've drawn out your comic but are unsure of what colors you want to use, a good place to start can be by coloring everything black and white, and then applying a gradient map on top to see what different color palettes might look like. For filtering over pre-existing colors, you can lower the opacity of a gradient map layer. By doing this, you could ensure that your original colors will still show through, but now they have a more harmonious color palette when combined with the gradient map. I like to use gradients with oranges, purples, and yellows at a low opacity to achieve a warm, cozy look for my colors. Using different layer modes also opens up a whole new avenue of possibilities, so be sure to experiment to find techniques that work best for your style. Those are the basics for how I use tonal correction layers when making webcomics in Clip Studio Paint. Check the description below for my social media links and more tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.